to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you.
But we're praying that God will save, that God will deliver, that God will bring back, and people will stop falling out with God. Look at your name, and I know that's right. They fall out with God. They get mad with God and call themselves walking away from their help. Because he is your help. Somebody say something to me. Amen. And so this morning I have the book of Joshua, the 23rd chapter. If you would turn to that particular passage of scripture, Joshua in the Old Testament, 23rd chapter. And also, if you could jot down the book of Psalms 137. Psalms 137, verses 1 through 6. Joshua, the 23rd chapter, verses 1 through 6. And then also note verse 12 through 16. We're going to start at Joshua, the 23rd chapter, first verse. Joshua, the 23rd chapter, verse number 1, is where we're going to start. And then ask Pastor Nita to read for us this morning. Does anybody have NIV Bible? You got NIV? Can you read? I want to hear, I want you to hear from King James, and I want you to hear from the NIV, Joshua, the 23rd chapter. I want you to just stand to your feet. I'm going to ask Pastor Nita and CJ to read one verse at a time, one from King James Version and the other one from the NIV. Verse 1, Elder Frazier. Joshua 23rd chapter, yeah, verse 12. Look like 12. That's 1. Okay. All right. Let's begin.
And it came to pass a long time after the Lord had given rest unto Israel,
yes,
of all their enemies round about, that Joshua waxed old and stricken in age.
Yes.
After a long time had passed, and the Lord had given Israel rest from all their enemies around them, Joshua by then a very old man.
Mm-hmm.
And Joshua called for all Israel, and for their elders, and for their heads, and for their judges, and for their officers, and said unto them, I am old and stricken in age.
Mm-hmm.
Summoned all Israel, their elders, leaders, judges, and officials, and said to them, I am very old.
Yes.
And ye have seen all that the Lord your God has done unto all these nations because of you. For the Lord your God is he that has fought for you.
You yourselves have seen everything the Lord your God has done to all these nations for your sake.
Yes.
It was the Lord your God who fought for you.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, I have divided unto you by lot these nations that remain, to be an inheritance for your tribes, from Jordan with all the nations that I have cut off, even to the great sea westward.
Mm-hmm.
Remember how I have allotted as an inheritance for your tribes all the land of the nations that remain, the nations I conquered between the Jordan and the Mediterranean Sea in the west.
Yes.
And the Lord your God, he shall expel them from before you, and drive them from out of all your, drive them out of your sight.
Mm-hmm.
And you shall possess these lands as the Lord your God has promised unto you.
Yes.
The Lord your God himself will push them out for your sake. He will drive them out before you, and you will take possession of their land as the Lord your God promised you.
Verse 6.
Be ye therefore very courageous to keep and to do all that is written in the book of the law of Moses, that ye turn not aside therefrom the right hand or to the left.
Yes.
Be very strong.
Be very strong.
Be careful to obey all that is written in the book of the laws of Moses.
Be careful to obey all that is written in the book of Moses.
Without turning aside.
Without turning aside.
To the right or to the left.
Yes, and the church said. Verse 12 through 16. I know this is a little lengthy, but I think it's needed so that we can get the full context of this particular chapter and the message that God is going to share with us this morning.
Verse 12.
Else
if you do in any wise go back to cleave unto the remnant of these nations,
yes,
even these that remain among you,
and
shall make marriages with them, and go in unto them,
yes,
and they to you.
But if you turn away and ally yourselves with the survivors of these nations that remain among you,
come on.
And if you intermarry with them and associate with them,
wow.
Know for a certainty that the Lord your God will no more drive out any of these nations from before you.
Yes.
But they shall be snares and traps unto you, and scorches in your sides, and thorns in your eyes, until you perish from off this good land which the Lord your God has given you.
Yes.
Then you may be sure that the Lord your God will no longer drive out these nations before you. Instead, they will become snares and traps for you, whips on your back and thorns in your eyes.
Yes.
Until you perish from this good land which the Lord your God has given you.
And behold, this day I am going to the way of all the earth, and ye know in all your hearts and in all your souls that not one thing has failed with all the good things which the Lord your God spake concerning you.
Yes.
All are come to pass unto you, and not one thing has failed thereof.
Now I am about to go the way of all the earth. You know with all your heart and soul that not one of all the good promises the Lord your God gave you has failed. Every promise has been fulfilled, not one has failed.
Yes.
Therefore, it shall come to pass that as all good things are coming to you, which the Lord your God promises you, so shall the Lord bring upon you all evil things. Until he has destroyed you from off this good land which the Lord your God has given you.
Yes.
But just as all the good things that, just as all the good things the Lord your God has promised you have come to you, so will he bring on you all the evil things that has threatened, that he has threatened, until the Lord your God has destroyed you from this good land he has given unto you.
Verse 16.
Yes.
When ye have transgressed the covenant of the Lord your God, which he commanded you, and have gone and served other gods, and bowed themselves to them,
come on,
then shall the anger of the Lord be kindled against you.
Yes.
And ye shall perish quickly from off the good land which he has given unto you.
If you violate the covenant of the Lord your God, which he commanded you, and go and serve other gods, and bow down to them, the Lord's anger will burn against you.
Yes.
And you will quickly perish from the good land he has given you.
And the church says,
amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for the reading, the hearing of thy word. Help it, O God, to continually settle in our hearts and in our spirits. Help us not to make the mistake that Israel had made, but us, we must go forward in doing the will as you so ask us to do. Give us this, and we thank in your son Jesus' name we pray. Our soul say, amen. Before you be seated, I tell you the name is a neighbor. There's a danger of fatal distractions. Come on, the danger of fatal distractions. The danger of fatal, you may be seated, the fatal distractions. We have read a whole lot so far this morning, And we didn't even go into the Psalms 137. We may be able to get into that particular, read those verses. We may be able to grab them before we leave, but I just wanted to admonish you, when you get an opportunity, read the 23rd chapter, that whole chapter of the book of Joshua.
Amen. Amen.
And as I was reading and meditating on fatal distractions, my mind kept on, as I read it, I kept on hearing what the Lord had given you, not promised you, but had given you. Amen. And the Lord has blessed us with many things, and sometimes we are not appreciative of those things that God bless us with.
Amen.
But I can say that Israel, they were blessed to have the promised land. It tells us that Israel was given the land to possess. They were given the land from the Jordan all the way over to the Mediterranean Sea. It's like a landlock. And today, they're fighting over the same land.
Amen.
Today. Because it is a strategic place in the world when it comes to that part of the region. So if a person is on a ship and they come across, coming from the Mediterranean or coming from the Jordan side, they got to come across the land. And God strategically gave all of that land to the children of Israel.
Amen.
Joshua, now at the end of his lifespan, he gathered all the leaders. You know, it's one thing when you get leaders and get them together.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's the leaders that will help the followers do the right thing.
Amen.
Somebody help me in this place. When I see a follower going astray, I always try to see who's the leader.
That's right.
Who's the leader? Where did they rep up? Where did they come from? So that's why I'm very careful. I'm very particular of people who say, I'm your pastor.
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Now, I don't want Brother CJ to be down somewhere saying, I'm my pastor, Bishop Frazier, and he's acting like,
yeah.
All right. I just thought I had you know, because Bishop Abbott was in my office this week.
What happened?
Bishop Abbott is down in Salisbury, down there where you go to school. And when Bishop Abbott was in my office, he had great compliments about CJ.
Amen.
Christopher. Yeah. What did you do? But these are the kind of reports that should come from you. Now, when you get a young man that go to school, and you got another bishop, that this young man been going to the church, come and meet his pastor and bring a good report, that's a good thing.
Amen.
Amen. Because going to school, there's a lot of distraction.
Amen.
I might as well say that. You know, we act like going to school is, you know, it's all bad things. It's not all bad, but there's a lot of distractions that can turn out bad. And some of them can turn out fatal. Well, I looked at Joshua getting old, and when he gathered the leaders together, he began to talk to the leaders and was telling them that he was old and getting ready to leave off the scene. But he was reminding them of the blessings that God had already gave them. Somebody say, already gave them.
Already gave them.
It's a difference in Joshua and Moses. In Moses' generation, the blessings in the promised land was promised to them.
Amen.
they received the promises, right? Joshua's generation actually possessed the land.
Amen.
Okay, and Joshua began to remind them that God had blessed you. And you know, sometimes God will bless us in some things, and just as sure as we sit in our seat, we act a fool and get distracted with the blessings that God has blessed me with.
Yeah.
Now, I just want to emphasize just a little bit about the blessings and about how God take care of us and how so easily the enemy calls us to look at something else. And here, I thought about sometimes when you take a trip, traveling, going somewhere. I don't know if you ever been to Florida or not.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to, I picked one, just going to Disney World. The average person that drive know that you have to get on the highway and go down 95. Somebody say something to me.
Amen.
And if you were like us, when we had children, when our children were young, every year we used to take that 15, 16-hour trip to Disney World.
And I remember that.
I didn't drive, and he remembers. but going to Disney World was a trip that I pretty much knew the road. And I knew what I was up against when it comes to driving, that this knew that certain places we were going to stop. One, to get some gas, get some rest, and pick up some souvenirs. I wish I had somebody to stop at Southwest Border.
Man.
Y'all know that. Come on, somebody say something to me. Y'all looking at me like, you know what? Yeah, and as soon as you pass Southwest Border, there's a hotel down there called Thunderbird.
Amen.
And the Thunderbird got the best fried fat bag. I knew people would say that. But if you went to Thunderbird, you'd get some nice, you know, it was a buffet. Thunderbird was a buffet. It was a hotel and a restaurant combined, and that Thunderbird had some good food in there. But I knew all those places. You know, when you know a place like that, you know how to get there, you know how to get back home. But I got an address last week, and the individual gave me an address, and they was telling me we had a meeting scheduled at a certain time. And I wasn't 100% sure where the place was, 100% sure where the place was. But I knew how to get to the area. And so I used my GPS. Somebody help me in this place.
Amen.
You know what I know, GPS will take you to where you want to go.
Amen.
Well, it'll take you all over the place.
Yes, it will. Yes, it will.
You don't know where you're going.
Yes, it will.
And so I'm relating this to the children of Israel. And possessing the promise. And at the same time, getting distracted and getting off course. And so when I used that GPS, I was going to the National Harbor, but I was going to a street that I heard of, but I've never been there before. And I couldn't figure out how my GPS was telling me to get off of 295 and go down like towards the 14th Street Bridge.
Wow.
Now I know what would have happened. When I got down to the 14th Street Bridge, I would have had to loop around and come back across the Woodrow Wilson Bridge to get to the harbor.
Right.
Now I would have got to the harbor. Somebody help me here.
Yeah.
I would have got to my meeting. But I definitely would have been late.
Wow.
You know, when you leave the church around 5 o'clock and you're going to be there at 5:30 and you got traffic on 295, come on somebody, help me in this place. Do the math.
Yeah, buddy.
Tell your neighbors and neighbor. Fatal distractions. Don't, it's a danger in fatal distractions.
they go to the harbor. And when I forego and didn't go in that direction and kept that one down 295, eventually I got ahead of the traffic. Because the traffic was going across the same bridge, Woodrow Wilson Bridge,
right,
that they were trying to direct me to go around and come across. But I was already ahead of it. Somebody helped me in this place.
Amen.
And so following direction, be on those journeys and on those trips and on going on wherever you're going, and you might need some gasoline. Mm-hmm. And you may just get off just to get some gasoline or get off just to get something to eat. And you see a sign that says food, and you get off and you drive to Timbuktu. Somebody help me in this place. Maybe I'm the only one that happened to in this place, but I'm telling you, there's some exits that you can take that take you, I don't know where you're at. You're in Hooterville, you're somewhere else, lost, amen. But you're at the mercy of the GPS navigation system. Well, distracting can take you off the road and take you way out of the way. But if you're not careful, you're going to find yourself all wound up off course.
Uh-huh.
I just want to say that I did the emphasis on Israel, and I wanted to make sure you understand that Israel were already in the promised land. They've already possessed what God had said he was going to give them. And sometimes when God bless you, the devil got a way of showing you something that always looked better. I'm just talking. And then you find yourself sometimes when you look at that thing that looked better, you're going to find yourself in a strange land. Find yourself in a strange place. It's nothing like being lost and don't know where you're going. And then your GPS system say, you on your own.
I hate this.
Now, you gotta, Rosa, you gotta get lost for a GPS system to tell you I don't know where you are.
Yeah, you messed up.
I've been that lost. Basically, if you have an older model car, or older model Garmin, or older model GPS, then you don't have all the latest updates.
That's right. That's right.
Somebody help me here.
That's right.
And your GPS system will tell you, it don't say you're on your own, but it was saying unfamiliar routes or
right,
something to that effect. But if you interpret what it say, it say, I don't know where y'all am. I just thought it was interesting because Israel was in the promised land. And they had possessed the land. And there was a few more things that needed to take place. But Joshua got them together and said, listen, there's a few more places that you need to possess, but I don't want you to mess around and marry, intermarriage in this land. I don't want you to, the remnant, the people that are still here, don't get tangled up with them because they're going to take you off course. Somebody help me in this place. And lo and behold, they did exactly what Joshua told them not to do. They lost focus of the prize that they have possessed. And so our theme this year, focus on the prize, amen, it's telling you that as Christians, we got to keep our eyes on the prize. We cannot afford to get off track.
Come on, man.
You listen, we didn't read Psalms 137. Read. Let's go into that. Let's go into that for a minute. Psalms 137, verse 1. Yeah, start at verse 1, and then let's get it from the NIV as well.
By the rivers of Babylon.
By the rivers of Babylon.
There we sat down.
Uh-huh.
Yea, we wept. When we remember Zion.
Yes.
By the rivers of Babylon,
we
sat and wept when we remembered Zion.
Yes, read.
We hanged our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof.
Yes.
There on the poplars we hung our harps.
For there, they that carried us away captive required us a song.
Mm-hmm.
For there, they that carried us away captive required us a song.
Yes.
And they that wasted us required us merit.
Yes.
Saying, sing us one of the songs.
Sing us one of the songs of Zion. Read, CJ.
For there our captives asked us for songs.
Mm-hmm.
Our tormentors demanded songs of joy.
Yes.
They said, sing us one of the songs of Zion.
Mm-hmm. This part right there. Sunday school lesson was talking about singing songs, praises unto God. Amen. Israel is always admonished to sing. Amen. They are always admonished to sing songs, sing a refreshed song, sing the songs unto God. Amen. Here we see that they were taken captive. Now, these individuals were taken captive are the same ones that possess the promised land. And you could say, well, you mean to tell me if I possess something that God has blessed me with, that I could lose it? I'm telling you, if you read this scripture, you're gonna find out that when you don't do what God tells you to do, no preacher, no prophet from hell can stop God when he allowed the enemy to come in your direction.
Amen.
Somebody help me in this place. So here now we see that Israel is being tortured. I mean, they sort of torment them now, playing with it. Sing me one of them Zion songs. Because you know them Zion songs will make you happy.
Yeah.
Somebody help me here. You get a real song, a real Zion song, it'll get you pumped up. Come on, somebody. I guarantee you, we can crank up in here and then start singing it. You folks that sitting there getting ready to go to sleep, you can do what? You shake yourself. Come on. You shake yourself when Zion began to step in. Amen. Sing one of those songs, but listen to what happened to the Zion song. Come on, read it.
Verse 4.
Uh-huh. Listen to Israel.
How shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land?
Mm-hmm.
How can we sing the songs of the Lord while in a foreign land?
How is it that Israel now is saying, I'm in a foreign land? Well, I read back in Joshua, the 23rd chapter, that God had already, Joshua told them, now the Lord have already given you the land, and you see that God wiped out your enemy. What are they doing in the 37th chapter? What are they, Saul, what are they doing in a foreign land?
Wow.
How did they get in a foreign land? Because he said that when you disobey God, he said he's going to allow them to whip you on your back, put pricks and thorns in your eyes. Some of them, they're going to carry you on out of your land. And we see that they're in, amen, a foreign land being tortured and taught and said, sing one of them songs. Come on, you in church, give me a little church song. Sorry, help me in this place. Read, verse 5.
If I forget thee, O Jerusalem,
yes.
Let my right hand forget her cunning.
Uh-huh.
If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand forget its skill.
Yes.
If I do not remember thee, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth.
Mm-hmm.
If I prefer not to keep them above my chief joy.
Yes.
May my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember thee.
Yes.
If I do not consider Jerusalem my highest joy.
We see that God have allowed them be taken captive. And when God allowed them to go captive, they left the promised land that they were in. They were taken from the promised land, taken to Babylon. And you that familiar with the story of Babylon, you know, they took all the best of the people, all the smart people, all the good people. Amen. They left trash. They left the trash folks. They didn't need to take the trash folks. Somebody ought to be here. Amen. They took the best folks. They took Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Right.
Amen. They took them on down into Babylon. And when they went down into Babylon, they were tortured and they were
they were made slaves again. And here we see a free people become slaves again. Amen.
Wow.
Amen. I'm looking at the United States of America. Somebody help me in this place. I'm looking at where we are right now as a country as a whole and how the country think that, amen, this country's going to be slaves again. But the devil is a lie. Somebody help me in this place. Come on, somebody say something to me. The devil is a lie. Somebody say, sing us one of those Zion songs. And what happened was Israel, they refused to sing Zion's song. They refused to praise God. Come on. They hung the harps up on the willow tree. I wish I had somebody say something to me. The musicians stopped playing the music, but I can tell you right now, I'm going to be like David. I'm going to give God some praise. Somebody say something to me. I know what Solomon said, amen, and what Solomon asked God to do. Solomon said, I don't want riches. I don't want everything that everybody wants. What I want is wisdom so I can guide your people. Come on here, in the right direction. Solomon said that I don't need money, but this is one thing that I do need. I need you to know that if your people forget you, and then give us a place that we can look. Israel can look to the east. Somebody help me here. They can look to where God is. Come on, somebody. David said, I look to the hills from which cometh my help. Come on, somebody help me in this place. You got to learn how to bless God no matter where you are. Because when Israel got in trouble, Solomon made it clear to God that his people can look to him and they can get some help and get some direction. Just looking in that direction.
Children of Israel. And when Moses went to the God with the God for deliverance,
Amen.
Huh? You know, there's distraction, especially in our mind.
Mm-hmm.
We can remember some things in our mind that cause us to go back.
Wow.
I'm preaching hard. Y'all just looking at me this morning. But listen, there are some distractions in your mind that will cause you to go back. You know, you in your mind, you be saying, you know, I'm better off when I'm selling dope.
Wow.
You had money, but you always looked over your shoulder.
Amen.
You ready to go to jail or get killed. So how was you better off?
Amen.
So I said, but I had money. But money ain't everything.
Money ain't everything.
You're helping somebody.
That's right.
I bet off when I had that guy. He was taking care of me.
Wow. Go ahead, Bishop.
You're beating all up inside your head. You thought he was taking care of you.
Right.
Punching you all in the face, all in the eye.
Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody. It's in your mind. Your mind will take the crazy stuff.
That's right.
It was mine when you were in the wilderness. We said we were better off in Egypt.
Right.
But we out here now, all we eat is manna and quail. We're better off in Egypt. I better have the gods in the leaves. I better have Egypt food.
Right.
Come on, somebody. They start murmuring. They start complaining. They start thinking about where they came from. Listen, you can't.
That's right.
Amen. But when you look back and want to go back, it's going to pull you back.
That's right.
So you got to understand, God is saying, I don't want you to go back. I want you to go forward. He told Moses, when they got to the Red Sea, amen, he said, listen, Moses, amen, we ain't going further. We ain't going further. We ain't going with God. Moses down on his knees praying, said, God, what should I do? Where should I go? Moses told God, told Moses, stop praying. You know, sometimes God tell you, stop praying. Situation that God has already told us what to do. Huh? We're praying. Somebody help me in this way. I'm in a horrible situation, Lord. I don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, everybody look at me. Just look at me. If you're in a horrible situation and you don't know what to do, there's something wrong with you.
Amen.
So I said, well, I don't have a problem. Let me give you that. You at home and you married, you down the road, and this guy beating all on you and you don't know what to do. I'm telling you, before you get married, should nobody hit you.
That's right. That's right.
Should nobody beat you upside your head.
Man.
You say, I love
ever.
Somebody help me in. Josh, you in a situation, and this boy, you go to college, you go to school, you ain't got to worry about that big old tall Ella Walker. Or medium-sized Sister Rosa. You ain't got to worry about none of them. You're in your own. You're our own man.
I'm 18.
Yeah, buddy.
Fresh bubbles. I ain't got to listen. Until you get in trouble.
That's right.
Every time you start doing what you want to do, you're going to get in trouble.
That's right.
Now, I'm hanging with these guys because I'm going to be part of the frat.
Mm-hmm.
You find yourself with a joint in your mouth.
Yeah, buddy.
Ain't nothing wrong with the frat. I ain't putting that sorority down. I'm just making a point. There's some people you can't even hang with.
Amen.
In this day and time. Some people you just can't be around. Because they'll pull you down. Oh, yes, they will. Well, you know, it's cold outside. It's 1 degree outside. My buddy pulled up in a BMW. I'm going to be in that BMW. You know what I know. He got a BMW with Virginia tags and he live in D.C.
Yeah.
Duh, something wrong with that picture.
Yes, sir.
You gotta understand, Israel was distracted the way you stopped looking at God. In the moment the devil can get you to stop looking at God, you're gonna get pulled away. Amen. If it was God that saved you and God that delivered you, it's the same God that's going to keep you.
Amen.
How is he going to keep me? How will God keep me? God going to keep you if you keep your mind on him. He going to keep you. He'll take you and keep you where you are. He'll keep you in the promised land. Amen. He'll prosper you in that land. Somebody help me here. He told Israel, Israel, I'm going to prosper you. You don't need God no more. I mean, come on, let's be honest. Come on, y'all.
Yeah.
Come on, be honest with me. And stuff starts getting so good, you don't even need God no more. I don't need God no more. Well, that's what Israel said. I don't need God no more.
Right.
Some of us, we get so bright, so smart, you know, we don't need God no more. Well, I tell you one thing for sure. Israel is my example in that Joshua, in that 23rd chapter, when Joshua called them together, he was getting ready to go off scene, and he said to the people, he said, listen here, amen, listen, keep on doing what God told you to do. You saw God wipe out these nations, you see the lands and the things that you have possessed, you see where you are, you're better off now than you were, amen, keep on doing what you're doing, amen. Don't turn to the left, don't turn to the right. Don't go back. Come on, somebody help me in this place. Amen. Whatever you do, amen, don't go back on God. Amen. After the 21st of January, don't go back. Tell your nation, don't go back. After stuff starts turning around and all the blessings that we already possess, don't give up on God. If God brought me this far, he'll take me a little further. Amen. I'm going to trust in the Lord because God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we're able to ask or think. Come on here, help me. Distractions. It can get us off course.
Right.
I dropped that word in me other me this morning or this week and I was studying and I was saying, wow, Lord, wow. And he was saying, yeah, the thing, you know, we're focusing and focus on the prize. Amen. Focus on the prize. Amen. And so if I stay focused on the prize, will I not see what's going on in the world? It doesn't mean, when you're driving a car, it don't mean you're not going to see what's happening all around you.
That's right.
You're supposed to see what's happening around you.
Yeah.
Amen. But you can't allow the stuff that's happening around you to distract you. To get you off course.
That's right.
Okay. The average person that's on the beltway that's driving 55 miles an hour and the police is on the sideline, the average person look at what's going on.
Amen.
They call it rubberneck.
That's right.
And what they do, they slow down to see what's going on. And if you're not skillful in driving, you'll find yourself the car pulling over, hit the police on the side of the road.
Amen.
And you would say, that a person's driving down a beltway straight, how would they pull over and hit the officer that had pulled somebody over? How would they hit that car?
Not paying attention.
They distracted. We're so smart now that we text.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Y'all help me here. Come on. We text on the phone while we drive. I'm talking to somebody here. I don't know why I'm going in this road, but I do know one thing. We do text and drive. Somebody help me here. Can I have a real honest person to text and drive? Can text a whole sermon.
Nah. Can't do it.
They made calls to talk to you. so you can talk in the car.
Yeah.
And tell the car, well, that's still a distraction.
Yeah.
Or the phone in the car automatically does. That's a distraction. Come on. It was a time when you couldn't even put a dog or a pair of dice hanging from your mirror.
Really?
It was illegal. Yeah, help me, bro. I don't worry about it. It was illegal to have dice hanging or dog babies or the, you know, trees that smell incense hanging from your mirror. It was illegal to have those things hanging from your mirror.
Right, anything that distracts you.
And the reason they said don't put them from your mirror because it'll distract you.
Maryland.
Please, let's not go there.
Right.
No, got a white car we got to deal with.
Right.
Come to the but there are things that the enemy is using that we don't. Listen, the thing that the enemy used to distract you, I can tell you right now, is not sin.
Mm-hmm.
You don't distract Christians with sin. You know, you think I'm kidding? You go out and try to catch some fish with no bait on the line. You gotta have some kind of bait that the fish, that will attract the fish.
Amen.
And so what's happening is that we're being distracted and pulled away from God.
Uh-huh.
It's easy to go to the monument on Sunday. Somebody give you some tickets to the Black History Museum on a Sunday. Somebody help me here. Give you, you know, free movie tickets so you can go see Fence on a Sunday at 11 o'clock. The devil is alive. You don't watch yourself, you will be so far out of the will of God. That's what happened to Israel. Go back and read that 23rd chapter. If you read Israel, you read the 23rd chapter, you read Deuteronomy of Joshua, you read Deuteronomy the 28th chapter, you see the first 13 verses
right.
In Deuteronomy 28, first 13 verses, and here we see Moses is telling this earlier generation, God gonna bless you.
Mm-hmm.
You do this and God gonna bless you. You do this and God gonna bless you. The rest of them,
that's right.
It's cursed.
Curses.
Yeah.
If you don't do this, this is what God gonna do. And you know what they, you know, people get mad because you say what God, you know, the things that God. Let me tell you something. You can get as mad as you want. I can tell you what God has said.
Amen.
I can't, there's no such thing as I got, you know, you can water it down or you can give it to a person. You can't even give the truth to people now in love.
Okay.
Amen. Wow.
The people will not honor, some people will not honor the truth in love. And so how did he do it? Well, Paul made it clear to us what's going to happen in the last day.
Yeah.
What's going to happen in the last day? Folks going to want to hear the truth, right? But they're going to deny the truth. They're going to have itching ears, ever learning, and never coming to the knowledge of the truth. Because they don't want to hear. It's almost like me talking to Elder Antoine. He young Timothy. Amen. Elder Antoine, don't be timid with folks. Preach the word.
Yes.
Paul told him, be instant in season and out of season.
So
if they don't want to hear you preach it anyhow,
yeah.
they walk away from you, walk out the church, preach it anyhow.
Yeah.
Somebody help me here. Well, they make a law and tell you, you can't talk about it. Preach it anyhow. It's hot. You don't have to warm it up. It's already hot.
Right.
Word of God is right, whether we want it or not. Israel took their eyes off of God, and something got them distracted. Caused them to look away from God. Just a look away, just a moment, can be fatal.
Yes. Wow. Amen.
It can be that fatal.
Yes.
We're outside today. I was real careful in how I sent the email out.
Mm.
I was real careful. I think I told you to wear layers,
yeah.
Casual clothes. something like that. And I said, take your time.
Man.
Get it? And I said, Multi, I said, it's icy. Something like that. What were you saying? I said, come on to church. Dress warm, because it's cold out here.
That's right.
Don't worry about putting on a suit if you don't have to. Just put some, you know. I wish y'all could have seen what I had on. I had this on, but I didn't want to have a sweater on top of it. You know, you had a suit jacket, I had a sweater on top of that. Slip on the sweater.
Wow.
Scarf, coat, hat, somebody up there. Because they said it's going to be 1 degree, feel like out there. So dress in layers.
Mm-hmm.
I told Pastor Nita, and I should have told them and didn't come to church and peel it off. You didn't say that, did you? No, I didn't say that. You can't tell folks to peel off clothes.
Yeah, don't.
People take it off.
Take you literally.
This has been getting all provocative and telling me to peel off our clothes.
Right.
Well, that's all they hear on the
internet.
Is peel off clothes. The devil is alive. Don't take much to get distracted. Folks play what they want, say what they want, do what they want. But don't you let the devil distract you. It can be fake. It can be real fake. I'm telling you right now, the Lord has been good to us. He's been good to you. Don't lose your promise. Don't lose your promise, lady.
Withholding nothing.